Thank you all for coming to this recital on a Monday night at a busy time of the year, at least for us teachers. And that was the third partita by Johann Sebastian Bach, a set of dances that that were based on these kind of set court dances, like the courante and the allemande and the sarabande, in the court of Louis XIV, one of the king's favorite pastimes was this new court dance source of entertainment, and it later became the tradition of ballet. And one of the court dances was the minuet. It started in the Baroque era and continued on into the Classic era, and we'll hear a minuet by a different composer right now after this. So the next composer is someone who's been getting a lot of notoriety nowadays for a very good reason. This was the first classical composer of African origin of great skill and renown. He was born in the Caribbean, so there's a little affinity there to me as well, since I was born in Montserrat. But Joseph Bologna was the son of a slave and her slave owner, born in Guadeloupe and trained in and educated in France, and he was not only a swordsman of renown across the continent, but he was also a very accomplished virtuoso violin player. As soon as late as maybe 5 years ago, the general music community knew that he had composed a few pieces for keyboard. It would have been harpsichord or the early forte piano. And there was only one that was published, the Adagio in F minor, which is a beautiful piece. But there's also a collection of sonatas. It's in the Vaughan notebook, and its authenticity was in dispute. And so I knew about these works when I was a graduate student in Florida, but didn't really pursue the research into it. And a colleague of mine who teaches at Elon, he actually gave a concert here earlier this semester and played a bunch of Joseph Bologna's works. He did the homework, and yes, they are authentic, and they're beautiful. And this is one of his sonatas in E flat major. The opening movement has the feel of an orchestral first movement of a symphony, and the second movement is the a graceful minuet. And you know, for Mozart and Haydn, we typically find three movements: fast, slow, fast. Joseph Bologna tended to only have two movements in his sonatas, so this may be similar to a Scarlatti sonata in that often you can pair two movements together and that creates a nice work with the contrast. So this is Joseph Bologna's sonata in E flat major.
Thank you.
The next piece is by Alexander Scriabin. There's a lot of interesting things that could be said about him. He wrote 10 sonatas, and this is probably my favorite. There's a slow movement and a fast movement, and they're played without interruption. At this point, I wanted to draw your attention to the piano that's on stage. It was not here 3 days ago. It's so thank you to the Steinway Gallery of Charlotte for providing us a piano for this weekend. We had a fundraiser yesterday. Our music department is trying to become an all Steinway school. And so when I first came here about 7 years ago, I realized that we had some challenges in the facilities department, and Steinway came in and gave an assessment of our inventory and told us a lot of things that we already knew. What we didn't know is that several of our pianos were over 70 years old, and some were over 90 years old, and so we've had an AME Zion organization, the Women's Homes and Overseas organization. They donated two Boston uprights that are in our practice rooms, and if you feel like you would like to invest in our music department and the young musicians who are being trained here at Livingstone, you can do so at our website at Livingstone, and there is a drop-down menu that says Steinway Project. And this is a concert grand. It's a Spirio piano, and I really enjoy playing it. When I was in graduate school, both for my master's and doctorate, all of the practice pianos for the piano majors were Steinways, and so it's nice to be playing on a wonderful instrument like this. This is Scriabin's Sonata in F sharp major. Hope you enjoy. wanted to say a few words about the next piece. It's by George Walker, who was the first African-American to win the Pulitzer Prize for music. He studied at Curtis. He also studied at Eastman, taught at Rutgers University for many years, and wrote over 90 compositions and fulfilled commissions from many major orchestras. He has a few piano sonatas, and I'm playing a movement from his second. And this is a set of variations, and it's masterfully constructed. It's kind of in the style of a passacaglia, it reminds me of the 32 variations in C minor by Beethoven, but whereas they both take a single phrase of music and present it in a number of various ways, in George Walker's case, he really deconstructs the DNA of that phrase. So these minor thirds are connected and in various ways, and he begins with octave displacement, and then different moods, and it's really ingenious the way he treats this theme. But again, the theme is very short, so with 10 variations, they go by very quickly. This is the first movement of George Walker's second piano sonata.
Thank you.
The final piece of the program is by Sergei Rachmaninoff. This is his 150th year, so all over the world. You'll be hearing a lot of Rachmaninoff this year. I was actually just in New York for a business trip and heard Olga Kern play an all Rachmaninoff short recital, and it was wonderful. And so with that fresh in my mind, with the inspiration or perhaps trepidation, I present Rachmaninoff's second sonata. He had two versions of this, and this is the second 1931 version. He originally wrote this in, or first published it in 1913. And I think the music speaks for itself. It's always been extremely popular within pianists of a certain capability. And it's been this monster that I've been reticent to tackle, but felt like this was the year. So I hope you enjoy Rachmaninoff's second piano sonata.